नमस्कार, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन्फॉर्मेटिव न्यूज़। इंडिया नेपाल एग्री टू डेवलप इनलैंड वाटरवेज। इंडिया एंड नेपाल रिकग्नाइज द अनटैप्ड पोटेंशियल ऑफ इनलैंड वाटरवेज इन ऑर्डर टू कंट्रीब्यूट टुवर्ड द ओवरऑल इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द रीजन। प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया एंड नेपाल टुक द लैंडमार्क डिसीजन टू डेवलप द इनलैंड वाटरवेज फॉर द मूवमेंट ऑफ कार्गो। द न्यू इनिशिएटिव वुड इनेबल कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव एंड इफिशियंट मूवमेंट ऑफ कार्गो। Second news is SBI launches UK subsidiary. The SBI has announced the launch of its UK subsidiary SBI UK Limited with an initial capital commitment of 2 to 5 million pounds from its parent entity. SBI became the first foreign bank in the UK to ring-fence its retail division from its wholesale business. SBI operates 7 branches in London. Third important news is Goa government to launch app-based taxi service. The Goa government has decided to launch its own app-based taxi service to some key tourist destinations in the coastal state. The state-run Goa Tourism Development Corporation, that is GTDC, invite the taxi operators to register with the new mobile application-based transport service. Currently, the tourist taxi operators run their businesses individually in Goa. Fourth important news is e-way bill to be rolled out in 5 states. E-way bill system for the intra-state movement of goods is scheduled to be implemented from 15th of April in 5 states. The new system is being implemented from the aforementioned date in Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Kerala, Telangana and Uttar Pradesh. E-way bill system for all interstate movement of goods was rolled out from 1st of April. Fifth important news is fast track court to try drugs cases in Manipur. Manipur Chief Minister Biren Singh inaugurated a special court at Cherep Court Complex in Imphal to try drug related cases. The fast track court will facilitate the speedy trial of offense related to narcotic drugs and psychotropic substance. Similar court to try crime against women was also inaugurated by Chief Minister on 27th June last year. Sixth important news is maritime trace to go electronic. The government has made the use of e-voice, e-payments and e-delivery orders mandatory across the maritime trades as it seeks to push digitization of trade of process. The government has also directed stakeholders to use the port community system, that is PCS. PCS is a centralized web-based message exchange platform for the Indian maritime community to exchange the documents. Seventh important news, Hina Sindhu was gold medal in 25M pistol. Hina Sindhu won India's 11th gold medal in pistol shooting at the 2018 Commonwealth Games in Gold Coast. Hina Sindhu has become the first Indian athlete to win 2 medals at the 2018 Commonwealth Games. India has so far won 20 medals including 11 gold, 4 silver and 5 bronze. Eighth important news, India to celebrate World Homeopathy Day. A 2-day scientific convention is being organized in New Delhi by Ministry of Ayush on the occasion of World Homeopathy Day on 10 to 11th April 2018. World Homeopathy Day is observed to commemorate the birth anniversary of the founder of the homeopathy, Dr. Christian Friedrich Samuel Hahnemann. The theme of this convention is Innovate, Involve, Progress, Exploring Science Since 40 Years. And the ninth important news is India's first electric locomotive. Prime Minister flagged off the country's first high-powered electric locomotive assembled in Madhepura in Bihar. The first locomotive is part of the joint venture of the railways with Alstom signed in 2015 and the first major FDI project in the rail sector. India will join countries like Russia, China, Germany and Sweden that have 12,000 horsepower and above capacity electric locomotives. 10th important news is railway link between Kathmandu and Raxaul. India will build a strategic railway link between Raxaul in Bihar and Kathmandu in Nepal to facilitate people-to-people contact and bulk movement of goods. The two prime ministers agreed to construct the new electrified rail lines, which will be financed by India. The three other railways projects in the pipeline are New Jalpaiguri, Kakrabhita and Nanu Tanwa, Bhairava and Nepalganj Road, Nepalganj. India and Bangladesh signed six pacts, including one of the construction of a 129.5 km long oil pipeline between Siliguri and Parbatipuri. The MOU on the oil pipeline is aimed at transporting diesel from India to Bangladesh. An agreement between Department of Atomic Energy, India and Bangladesh Atomic Energy Commission was signed. The other MOU was between Prasar Bharati and Bangladesh Betar. 11th important news is IGI Airport is in the top 20 busiest airport list. New Delhi, India. New Delhi Indira Gandhi National Airport entered into the league of the top 20 busiest airport in the world for 2017 in terms of traffic volumes. The GMR Group run New Delhi Airport jumped from 22 rank in 2016 to 16th rank as per the Airport Council International (ACI). Hartsfield-Jackson Atlanta International Airport, that is ATL, was ranked the busiest airport in the world. 13th important news is NABARD frames self-healing norms for RRBs. NABARD has come out with the Prompt Corrective Action, that is PCA, framework for regional rural banks, that is RRBs. The framework is aimed at enabling RRB that fail to meet prudential requirements like capital adequate to take self-corrective actions. The PCA will be invoked if RRBs fail to meet the capital to risk weighted assessed ratio assessed and profitability return of on assessed. 14th important news is anti-dumping duty on phosphorus pentoxide. Based on the recommendation of the Directorate General of Anti-Dumping and Allied Duties, the Revenue Department has imposed an anti-dumping duty on import of phosphorus pentoxide from China. The duty has been imposed for 5 years. Phosphorus pentoxide is used as a powerful desiccant and dehydrating agent and is a useful building block and reagent in the chemical industry. 50 important news is Andhra Pradesh to get happiness department. The Andhra Pradesh government will soon constitute a happiness commission that will take up a series of programs to promote happiness in the state. The commission, which will work under the Department of Planning, will be headed by the Chief Minister. AP became the second state in the country to introduce an exclusive Ministry of Happiness in April 2017. Madhya Pradesh is the first state. The 16th important news is UIDAI puts digitally signed QR code. The Unique Identification Authority of India, that is UIDAI, has brought in secure digitally signed QR code on e-Aadhaar that will contain the photographs of Aadhaar holder to facilitate better offline verification of an individual's. A QR code is a form of a barcode which contains machine-readable information. e-Aadhaar is an electronic version of Aadhaar that can be downloaded from UIDAI website. 17th important news is Lionel Messi named UN Ambassador. The UN World Tourism Organized has appointed FC Barcelona Argentina star Lionel Messi as an ambassador to promote responsible tourism. The UN body defines responsible tourism as tourism that helps maximize the sector's benefits. Responsible tourism minimizes the negative impact of tourism on the environment, cultural heritage and the societies across the globe. The 18th important news is India Swaziland signed two agreements. India and Swaziland have signed two agreements in the field of health and medicines and vice department on 9th April. Agreement deals with granting of the vice waiver for the diplomats and official holding relevant passports. The other agreement is to the ensure cooperation in the field of health and medicines. The agreement was signed in the presence of Indian President Ramnath Kovind. 19th important news is Indian men's table tennis team strike gold. The men's table tennis team won the gold medal by beating Nigeria table tennis team in Commonwealth Games 2018 at Gold Coast. India put themselves ahead with the help of Sarath Agnatha's win over Bode Abidin of Nigeria in the men's single event. This is India's 9th gold medal at the Games. India is now standing at the third spot on the point table with 18 medals in total. The 20th important news is India bagged first ever gold in badminton. India mixed badminton team claimed the gold medal on day 5 of the 2018 Commonwealth Games in Gold Coast. India beat Malaysia on the back of a strong shuttle play from Aswini Ponappa, Satvik Rankareddy, Kidambi Srinath and Saina Nehwal. This is the country's first mixed team badminton gold at any edition of the Commonwealth Games. Thanking for you. I hope this information is very beneficial for all competitive exams. Thank you once again.